freshman, Amy. That's the freshman.
Who's that?
Your little guy.
No.
He's not a freshman.
Our number, our number one boy today.
Let's go, Hawks! Whoopsie. A little too high. Nice job, Hawks. Let's go get them.
Go, Kimmy.
He says it's feeling better today. He didn't run times well with us.
Well, Schember, I made Schember come run this with me a couple, like a month ago. So when he.
probably pounded down the course a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, you should have seen it before he ran it.
Yeah, we're really pretty lumpy. Probably just rolled him like a
sausage. That's obvious. That is one of the big things that we're going to work on over the next year.
Well, the more it gets run on.
Yep.
Like you said, just having this and your other invoy.
It's going to get better and better.
And we have a dual meet with our kids. I mean, that's a 100 some kids the night before you're
in. Well, and we have another 100 middle schoolers running this afternoon.
Oh, here?
Yeah. 2:00. Oh. I know. We had to do what we had to do.
That's who do you race today?
Handy. They have like 30 girls, 27 or something like that. They have like 50 plus kids.
Well, Ted's doing that.
Is he?
Teddy's
over.
Cool. I didn't know who I was going to see.
Oh, yeah, he's been there quite a while.
That's right.
Oh, yeah, he was at Central, and now he's at Handy. He's been doing Handy for a few years now. Russ is doing a nice job at the high school level.
He is.
He's getting numbers out.
It's
just hard for him to get kids in the summer, like, you know, like anybody.
Yeah. He asks good questions and gives good feedback, though, and he's supportive. I think.
I've tried to encourage, like you and I've talked, we try to encourage this Bay County, especially Bay County. Get to those Mythica clinics. You're basically self-proclaimed.
Yeah.
I mean, you just learn stuff.
Is he a younger guy?
He's our age, maybe. Yeah, okay.
He's older than me.
I was guessing somewhere.
We worked together when we first got hired at one of the alternative schools.
Sit at the table and have
good
our
job,
own.
Ladies.
Okay, should be able to see them over there at the Pines. My favorite turn on the whole course, right there. I don't know. I just like it. It just feels neat. I love running through there. Let's go, Hawks! Shebby Lise. Sheb Julia. Good job. Let's go, Emmy. Nice job, Emmy. Let's go, Kylie. Nice job. Hey, be tough in the middle, right? You know, it's gonna hurt at some point. You can handle it. You can handle it.
Good job, Mackenzie.
Let's go, Tara.
Oh, now you got somebody to race.
Let's go, Tara.
Great, you too.
Nice job. Look ahead. Go, Zara.
Atta girl, Macy.
Nice run going. You got a nice run going.
Nice job, ladies. Keep looking up. Keep racing. Come on, Eleanor. You're doing great. Nice job, Eleanor.
They're around the corner, over by the bus loop. But you see, like,
yeah, that's what I was just going to point out. So if you can see the future when we can really have spectators, you can see over there, you can see it here. go, Emmy. Nice job, Emmy. Go, Kylie.
Sorry, I abandoned my duties. I was getting some feedback on the course because what a historic day that we ran a meet here, a high school meet, a legitimate high school meet. Allie and the girls are waving. I don't know if you can see them way down there because they're tiny in my camera. But this was a pretty historic day. I'm still trying to gather. I'm guessing somewhere between 1975 and 1985, roughly, the last time we ran a high school meet here. I have no idea what the course was. I'm going to try to dig that information out, but pretty historic day that we're back here, and the feedback's been good. I think it's, I'm not known for making racetracks, but I think this one's going to run pretty fast eventually, but I'm known for making, I sound like I'm bragging, but I make courses that are spectator friendly and real and fair, so I think that's what we got. Let's see here, I'd like to see Kylie one more time. I might have to go to the finish though. I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna jog to the finish. I can do that now. I can do that now, guys. Watch. This is jog.
I can see it.
This is jog. I did 8:30s on the course last night. I'm coming. Coming for you, Plude.
Alright.
Okay. What a day. Be nice when it's done. It's been fun. Everybody's been great. I picked the right guests to come to help us learn, and they've been so awesome. I love it. So sorry I didn't move the camera much for that race, but sometimes just leaving it is better because no matter what I do, I'm missing people, but moving it, I don't know. Cameraman's not my job, coaches. It's hard to do all that and be meet manager, but I'll gladly do it. It's fun, but I'm just saying, sometimes here or there I have, I'll drop the ball on one thing or another when I have too many balls in the air. I'm sure you guys get that. So, I'm getting tired, long day. We're not done, we still have to host middle school meet later this afternoon. I actually think conditions are, with the wind picking up, it's knocking the humidity down, so running the shorter course too, some of those faster kids, they could run pretty fast. Hi. Is it?
Yeah, it's wrong. It's always it's like a 20-something.
It's off by 10 minutes.
Yeah. We're confused on what it was.
Yeah.
Because down there, it's like a, when we came, the last person we saw ran like a 7:30.
But Coach Wilson might be able to make it right.
Where's that elementary or the bus driver's? Is it over there?
It's like where that yellow tree is, through there.
All right.
Probably, roughly.
We had a scoring issue.
You did?
You doubled one of my girls up and one can miss it.
Talk to Brian. All right. He's fixing the clock for... Is that? Okay. He'll fix it.
And I never started my timer. That was my fault.
Yeah, he'll get it. Because we only have to have it before the finisher comes, so I think that's probably what he was thinking. How was your run yesterday? How much did you do?
I did 1.1 miles.
Good.
I did 1.3.
That's a great test, isn't it? How did it feel? Did you have any pain at all, or just?
I don't really move my arm too much.
No, and the thing that we have to be careful of is we want to make sure that generally you're running where the footing's good because we don't want you to fall, obviously.
Yeah, we ran down tight.
Yeah, so pay a little attention to that. And I don't want to make you nervous just because I'm a nervous person, but pay a little attention to that, and I'm glad that's a huge stop now. Keep talking with your mom and dad about it. I'll keep checking in with you. The fact that we got you doing stuff this week is awesome. And we can continue to go from there. So I think they got, yeah. So now it's reasonable.
Yep.
I'm within a second.
Good job.
I think we're gonna get through the worst part, and it's actually with the breeze knocking the down and with it becoming overcast.
guess it might be better conditions for the middle school races this afternoon than it was for some of these races.
Yeah.
But it did. I knew it was supposed to be 80 today, so I knew we were going to have a little bit of a weather issue. But all my coaching friends assure me that those are things that I can't worry about because there's nothing to do about it.
I have a question.
Sure.
When can I,
October 24th. Not necessarily.
We didn't?
Okay, so I know we did, but we don't know. If we don't have the county meet on the 24th, we're going to have a tournament race. We will have a race that day. The MHSAA stuff. They might add a round and it might be that day. That's what we thought was going to happen when we canceled. We don't know what's going to happen. So, but I don't know. That's not going to be... Like, when you race is going to be Dr. Purchase and up to your mom and dad more than me.
I really want to run
I know you do,
Saturday.
But, like, the third? I don't think they'll let you run the third, but...
Well, I go back to Dr. Purchase.
I know. So, then it would be the 10th, and then the 17th and the 24th. We've got lots of time left, so...
You know.
It's not, that part's not up to me, so that's the answer to that question. I will let you race when everybody else is comfortable with letting you race, but, and I know you're anxious, but let's give it a little more time to make sure you get a little strength there.
Okay.
Well, here.
I feel I can run in this. I mean, I've ran in it before.
I know, but you're going to have to really mentally be tough because, you all set?
Yeah, all set. We won the meet now.
Did you? Nice job, O'Toole.
Good job, Olivia.
Yeah, so I don't want to be in a hurry. We got to make sure it's going to be safe for you to do it.
Like,
Zara?
I just want to get back.
I know you do.
Job,
but the fact that I didn't think we would have you doing anything right now. All right. And we did. We had an all right week of training. And it seems like we can continue to appropriately elevate things a little bit. But doing workouts where you're trying to go fast, trying to race, I think it's a little too soon. But it's up to... Nice job, Tara.
Good job.
Good finish, Tara. It's a little too soon. Probably, but that's more off the doctor purchasing your mom and dad. So I'll only tell you no until they tell me that.
My mom seems like she's
I'm just worried about you falling or something, which I know how often does that happen.
Yeah. I don't think
we just watched a girl fall. So
she fell?
Yeah, because she was like she was showboating in front of the camera. She went around the corner and coaches were commenting on it and she was like laughing or something. She just went down. She lost her footing. She got up and was sure okay. But yeah, she was like having fun with the camera. And, you know, that's why you concentrate on what you're doing, right?
I don't like looking at. I was actually walking by, saying like, oh my gosh, I have to finish or whatever, and I didn't notice the camera was here. And I was like, oh shoot.
Yeah.
Whoops.
Nice job, girls. Nice job, girls.
Nice job, Riley.
Nice job, Riley. Nice job, Savannah.
Good job, Savannah.
Nice job, Julia.
People were saying how long the last mile is. Like, it looks forever.
Yeah.
Good job, Julia.
It should be an advantage to the racers, but when it's so hot and humid, it takes its toll on you mentally. But having longer straights and gentle turns should be an advantage. But when the conditions are tough weather-wise, which they're a little bit tough today.
I wish there were trees.
I know. We want to plant more, but that's... We want to plant more. Nice job, Elise!
Good job,
nice race!
Yeah, they cut down, like, trees over here last year.
Yeah. I think because the boys had still some borderline but better conditions, they ran what I saw with their race generally, and not just our kids but even other kids from other schools. They did a little bit because of the humidity, but they ran relatively close to what we ran at Mount Pleasant, which has been running super fast. But as the day's going on, it's getting harder because it's 80 degrees and humid. Nice job, Brooke. Nice job.
Oh, yeah.
And look at what they did for me, so I have to do that for them. Right? That's how we are. You guys didn't know that, right? Did you? So much. Because you didn't get to see it. It's all, most of it's behind the scenes. Like, you didn't see us after you guys left yesterday, and after middle school left yesterday, we were here another hour, hour and a half worth of course.
Are you going to this course up for the rest of the
year? No, well, we're going to pull all the stuff because we don't race here for 2 weeks. But then when we set up some stuff for the Heritage Invite, then we might leave some of it up because then White Pine hosts here. So White Pine hosts here that Friday, the 9th. We host here the 10th. Then they host here the next week. And then we don't know after that. But then we host the regional meet. So like almost every weekend there's a race here. So we're going to leave some stuff up, but not everything.
I wish I was doing this. I would like running here.
I think so, and I think when we get really good conditions and when we get to come, like if we were able to run the full regional field here, because the problem when you get these long stretches is when you have gaps, it's hard to mentally stay focused, and you just kind of settle in and let people go or drift back, right? Stuff like that happens. But I think if you doubled, like, so next year we could host a meet here and double the size of the field, and you're in contact a lot more, racing more people.
Good job, Emmy.
Good job. I think that'll change the way we look at the last bit too, and then these long straight stretches we're gonna like because we can just get rolling.
Yeah.
It's just a awkward year completely, right? So
yeah, we're like a lot of these things, it's not really.
Yeah, I know, and we've had to get creative, and that's where this started.
Which is cool because then you're supposed to.
We are. Mr. Thorington asked me about that, and I said, well, as a matter of fact, I'm thinking of it being more like a late August race, though, instead. So moving it back to be our early season race, but keep it relatively small and run it like we run practice later in the evening so it starts to cool off. Because otherwise, if we go to a meet late, if we go to an early season meet somewhere, a lot of times we're running at 3:30 or 4 o'clock right in the heat of the day. And putting the wrong emphasis on what we're trying to do for a first meet of the year, right?
Come on, Kylie.
Nice job, Kylie. Nice job.
Good job, Kylie. Good job, Kylie.
So especially now that we got